Hello, and in this video, I'll be covering how to change the internal oscillator frequency and how to set up a timer on a PIC. First, let's go over the hardware configuration for the current setup. Like previously, I have two LEDs connected to RB6 and RB7, and then a single switch connected to RB1. Now let's get to coding. Now I've preset up some of the code here, and what was added is the libraries for stdint and stdbool, just is to better manage variables. And then I forward declared the interrupt service routines. Then in the main, I have set both LEDs as outputs on RB7 and RB6, and then the button as input on RB1. And then I set the LEDs to low. Then I enable the interrupt priorities, and then I enable the global interrupts. And then at the bottom is the interrupt service routines with global interrupt enable and disable on execution. First, we want to look at the datasheet. And to set the internal oscillator's frequency, we are going to adjust oscillator config. And we're going to adjust the multiplexer to 8 MHz. Now, this IC's default configuration is 1 MHz, which is potato slow. Now, here we have the oscillator control register. What we want to change in this register is IRFC, which stands for the internal oscillator frequency bits, to 7 hex. And then, just to make sure we stay on the internal oscillator, we are going to reset the system clock select bit to 3 hex. Then we're going to watch the internal oscillator frequency stable bit until the oscillator is stabilized. Now we just copy the register name. And now back to the code. We start with oscillator control bits dot IRFC equals to 0x07x. And then next is then OSCON bits SCS is equal to 3. And then we wait for the oscillator to stabilize. So while oscillator configuration bits IOFS is not equal to 1, then we wait until that passes by and then do our code setup. Now, this is all you need to change the frequency of the internal oscillator. And next what we do is we change in our configuration bits header. We change our XTAL frequency to 8 million Hz. Now unfortunately, there's not much to show on this, so the best way is to demonstrate it with a timer. So we refer back to the datasheet and we start configuring timer 0. So the bits in timer 0 are timer enable, and then do we want the timer to operate as a 16-bit timer or an 8-bit timer? Then next we select the clock source, which is going to be the internal oscillator, which makes it function as a timer and not a counter. And bit 4 is irrelevant for timers, as it's only used in counter mode. Then our third bit is the prescaler assignment, which either enables or disables the prescaler. And then we have our prescaler select, which is how much we reduce the clock of the timer for our calculations. Now we copy the register name. And then we start configuring the timer. First, what we do is disable the timer with T0CON bits dot TMR0 on equals 0. Then we set if we want it as an 8-bit or 16-bit counter. So we copy this line and we change this to T0 8-bit equals 1. Then we select a clock source for our timer, which is T0CON bits dot T0 CS, and we set it to 0, so we use the internal oscillator as the clock source. Now bit 4 is irrelevant, so we skip that, and then we select our prescaler with TCON bits PSA equals 0 to enable the prescaler of the timer. And the last thing is we select the prescaler value that we want, which is done via TCON 0 bits T0 PS equals 2. So what we have in essence is our timer is disabled first, then we select our timer to be an 8-bit counter, then we select the clock source to be the internal oscillator, we enable the prescaler by setting PSA to 0, and then we set our prescaler to 8. So 1 to 8 format. Now note on some PICs, the instruction frequency is the oscillator frequency divided by 4, which can be seen on the datasheet by the clocking scheme. The microcontroller clock output, whether from an internal or external clock source, is internally divided by 4 to generate 4 non-overlapping quadrant clocks. So effectively, since we set the oscillator to 8 MHz up here, we're actually running at 2 MHz instruction frequency. Now, why I've picked this specific configuration is because you have every 255 cycles, you will have an overflow on the timer, which is equal to 1 milliseconds, which can be calculated via this very professional piece of paint over here. So you have your time per cycle is 4 over your clock frequency. Time per overflow will be your time per cycle times your prescaler times 255. So in essence, what you got is 4 divided by 8 MHz equals 0.5 microseconds. And then your time per overflow will be 0.5 times 8 times 255, which is 1.024 milliseconds. Next, what we're going to do is set up an overflow interrupt for the timer. It's when we refer back to the datasheet, we go down and we see all the associated registers. On every clock cycle, timer 0 low will be incremented. Timer 0 high is only applicable when using the PIC in 16-bit counter mode. The INTCON register, which holds the timer 0 enable bit and the timer overflow flag. Now, what I don't mention in the associated registers is the timer 0 priority bit, which is located in the INTCON 2 register on bit 2. Now back to the code. Now to enable the interrupt for timer 0, we first set INTCON bits dot T0 IE equals 1, and then in the INTCON 2 register, we set T0 interrupt priority equals to 1 to set it to the high priority interrupt. And then finally, before we go into an infinite loop, we enable timer 1. Now, what this interrupt will do is every time the counter reaches a value of 255, it will reset and then set the timer 0 interrupt flag, which we have set to trigger every 1.025 milliseconds. Now, next, what I'm going to do is use the timer to blink an LED. So we start with declaring a global variable of size unsigned 8 bits. We'll call it blink underscore count equals 0. Then we go to our infinite loop and we say if blink count is greater or equals to 200, then toggle the state of the green LED. Now on a high priority interrupt, we say if INTCON bits dot timer 0 interrupt flag is true, then increment the value of blink count. Then we reset the interrupt flag, and this will now blink the LED at 200 millisecond intervals approximately. Now, as shown by the green LED, we are blinking at approximately 200 milliseconds intervals. Now, next, what I'm going to do is a non-blocking debounce using the timer. We start with another global counter variable of type unsigned 8-bit int. Call it button count, and that equal to 0. Then we declare a global boolean, and we call it button underscore press, and that's equals to false. Now we go to our main loop, start with an if statement, and the if statement is if not button press, then we nest an if in that, and then we test if the button was pressed with port b bits dot rb1, then we set the button press boolean to true. Then we have an if statement underneath that that says if button press is true, we nest another if button count is greater or equals to 40. Now that 40 can be any number you wish it to be, then we nest an if else in. Then we test if port B RB1 is still true. Toggle the blue LED, flat B bits. OB6 is equal to the inverse of flat B LB6. We reset the button press variable to false and set the button count equals to 0. Now if port B is not true, we just reset the variables once the button is no longer pressed. Now after this statement is done, we go down to our ISR. We add a if statement there as well. And we say, if button press is true, increment button count. Now we program the PIC. Now when the green button is pressed, the blue LED will go on. Seems like my debouncing was incorrect, so we go back to our if statement and we increase the 40 to 80. Program again. And let's see if the debouncing works properly now. There we go. Now to recap the code, we added stdint to enable us to use the macros for using uint8. We included stdbool that we can use booleans, our oscillator config. We clocked up the internal oscillator to 8 MHz, and we made sure it stays on the internal oscillator. Then we wait for the oscillator to stabilize at 8 MHz. Then we set our inputs and outputs for our LEDs and buttons. Then we set our LEDs to low. We disabled the timer at first. We set the timer to be in 8-bit counting mode. We select the clock source to be the internal oscillator, and then enable the prescaler and set the prescaler to a 1 to 8 ratio. Then our interrupt priorities are enabled. Then we enable the interrupt for timer 0. Then we set the interrupt priority of timer 0 to high priority. Then we enable the global interrupts, and then we start the timer. And then in the main loop, we test if the blink counter is either greater or equals to 200. Then we toggle the green LED with LED B7. Then for the button debouncing, we test if the button has been pressed. If not, read RB1 on port B, and then if the button has been pressed, set the button pressed true. If the button has been pressed, check the button counter, and if that is greater or equals to 80, read port B again, and if it is still high, toggle the blue LED on LED B7, then reset our variables to false and 0. And in the high priority interrupt, every time the timer overflows, increment the blink counter. I see now that I never reset the blink counter. We add that to the blink code and we set that to 0. Now we should actually have a better... Okay, I'm quickly going to program the PIC. Then we should have a better result. Strange that that worked. Okay. So we just added the blink counter reset. And in the global interrupt enable, in the high priority interrupt, we have the blink counter that's incremented every time the counter overflows. And then if the button has been pressed, increment the button counter, and then we reset the global interrupt flag. And that's how to configure the internal oscillator of a PIC microcontroller and how to set up a timer to use for blinking LEDs and debouncing buttons. Any parts that I have used will be linked down in the description, as well as any code that I've written will be linked to my Git. A like, share, comment, and subscription would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day. Oh, by the way, I have solar panels for a project at some later stage. Cheers.